It's not my fault. It just happened.
Later, kid.
Troy's hurt and he was asking for it.
Don't worry about it. I was gonna bench him anyway. He runs fine, but he couldn't hold onto a ball with a handle.
Too bad.
Are you kidding me? My face looks like the Australian outback.
More like the surface of Mars.
Mars! No, it's not Mars. I mean, a little bit Mars, but no.
Is this it, Doc? Or should we expect other surprises?
Well, obviously, Duncan's innate strength and resilience have been growing steadily since birth, but his natural fight or flight response created a hyper-stimulated state which manifested itself as incendia, respiro. It's fire breath. Yeah, you have it, Duncan. You'll learn to control it in time, but until then, you're just gonna have to stay out of situations with a potential conflict.
Like high school?
Like high school. I remember high school. That didn't work out well for me.
What I'm asking is, when will Duncan constitute a threat?
To humanity? Duncan? No, no. He's a sweet boy. He's not a pandemic.
It's only a matter of time before...
Duncan.
Hi, Mom.
Whose brilliant idea was it to bring Duncan here?
How have you been, Margaret? It's been a while. Look, I don't like this either, but there was a little incendia respiro incident at school, and...
That's what we call a your problem. I have a legal contract with Megtap stipulating my son have as normal a life as humanly possible.
And that's exactly what I'm doing, Margaret. Your son's a fine kid, especially for a boy without a father. I'd be happy to give you my two cents about him over dinner sometime. Son of a buck!
Not bad, huh?
Very interesting.
Oh, baby.